Hi there, this is Abhishek, and in this video I will talk about the case study related to correlation. So here our correlation case study starts with a question that does a study for long hours result in high marks? Well, in many cases it is true, and we know that it is a positive correlation because if you will study for long hours, you will get good marks. But if we look at the data that I have, which is a small data set, and it gives us the indication by looking at the observations that if somebody is studying for 10 hours in a week, then the person is getting 20 marks. If he's studying 40 hours, then 67 marks out of 100. 50 hours, then 36. So that means if he's studying 10 hours less, the person is getting 67. So one can debate that whether it is really good for studying for long hours. Like in this case, person is studying 80 hours, he's getting 81 marks. However, when the person is studying 70 hours in a week, the person is getting 56% or 56 marks out of 100. So is it really good studying for long hours at an aggregate level or in a general level? So to find out the generality or a general sense from your data, and in most cases, the data will be not as small as it is currently present here. It is just for demonstration. But when you have, let's say, hundreds or thousands of students' data, then it is really interesting to see whether if they are studying long hours, then it is resulting in the high marks or not. So to identify correlation for our case study, we need to right click and go to new sheet object. Since we will just get one value from this data set, we will use text object to represent or to get the correlation. We'll put equals to and then enter the formula corel, and within that we will mention hours and marks, right? And then click OK. So what we get is 0.84, which is near to 1, and says there is a very strong positive correlation between the number of hours that you study and marks. So at a general level, one can make a good claim with the help of correlation value that yes, if you will study a long hours, then you will definitely going to get a good mark. Well, this is how you can solve these kind of tricky scenario with these statistical significant figures to prove your point. However, when we will make this case study a little bit more elaborate, let's say apart from capturing the number of hours that person is studying, we also want to capture the number of hours person is spending on social media or on other activities. Or let's say we want to combine some kind of an activity that studying and as well as playing for a college or for a school, then what are the marks that person is getting? Well, these are all these interesting stuff which can give an interesting result when you are mixing up the cases, and you can get a good correlation values which are not only dependent on the number of hours that you are studying, but number of hours you are spending on social media, number of hours spending on the games, etc. in your entire week. So that's pretty much all. Very quickly I wanted to cover related to a QlikView case study. I wanted to give a little bit idea about how you can solve such situations or such questions with statistically significant results. So I'll meet you in the new video, the new topic.